Hi everyone, it's Sarah from Kettle with This Book. I'm doing my In My Mailbox. I'm very late. I am wrapping up my semester at college, so I'm pretty tired. I haven't even started studying for my finals yet, and I haven't done most of my papers yet either, so I'm just, I don't know, it's just really exhausting to end a semester, but I'm doing In My Mailbox from this past week. So I'll start with what I got from NetGalley on my Kindle, and the first book that I got is Spin by Katherine McKenzie from HarperCollins, and it's about, they just want to they get what they want, I guess. I don't know. I'm really unprepared today. I don't know what all the books are about, but mostly because I'm tired. But that was from HarperCollins. And then I have There You'll Find Me by Jenny B. Jones. And it was from Thomas Nelson Inc. Yeah, Thomas Nelson Inc. And it's, I don't know what it's about. Oh, here's the summary. 18-year-old Finley, seeking God, quiet time to prepare for an audition at a prestigious music school, music conservatory, I'm sorry, and knowledge of the land her deceased brother loved, spends senior year in Ireland where teen movie idol Beckett Rush, equally troubled, desires her company. So, that sounds interesting. It's about, I guess, meeting a celebrity and finding God, and if you couldn't tell, I like books like that. So, I got quite a few books from the library this week. I got them on Sunday, so. I got Sisters, Insanity by Gail Forman. And I really have no idea what it is, but it's by Gail Forman, so I was really, really excited to get it. Actually, she came to the library right by where I am, and my friend Runa actually got to go see her and talked about this and her, if I stay and where she went, and I didn't actually get to go. I had an obligation to one of my best friends, so... to go to the choir musical eggnog thing that we do as first years. So I did that instead of going to see Gail. But that's okay. It was fun too. So plus Runa got to tell me what happened and stuff, and she also wants to read this book now. So anyway, it's Sisters Insanity by Gail Forman. I got Past Perfect. I love this cover. It's so cute and pretty. And it's by Lila Sales, the author of Mostly Good Girls, which I've never read. It says it's for fans of Meg Cabot. And I really love Meg Cabot. I haven't really read her in a while, but I used to love her so much. So yeah, I'm excited about this one. It sounds really adorable. I feel like I'm gonna sneeze. Hopefully I won't. Okay. Awaken by Katie Kavinsky. I don't know if I said that right at all, but sorry. I don't think I said it right, but I love the cover, and I was like, ooh, I need to read this book. I forgot about it. And so I went and found it on my Goodreads and was like, yeah, I need to get this book. And I think it's a world where everything is done on the computer, like, everything. So I think it's a dystopian. So I love it. And it sounds really good. So I'm excited to read it. I also got Imaginary Girls. The premise is so interesting. It's always been interesting to me. It's by Nova Rensuma, I think. And I got this from the library also. And I love the cover. I really always did. And the premise is just, she, like finds a girl floating in her school pool or something like that, and sounds creepy and scary, and I don't know, it just sounds like something I would like. So I finally got this from the library after months. I also got Eve by Anna Carey. Okay. This is a dystopia. It's an apocalypse novel, I think. And I think it's about you're not supposed to, like, men are, I don't know if it's this one or if it's another one. I'm not sure, but I know this one is, I know it's apocalyptic. It's after the end of the world, and so I decided to pick it up. I've been seeing it everywhere, so I was like, why not? And so, yeah. I got, this one really sounds good. It's Damage by Anya Parrish, and it's like, she has an imaginary friend, and like, when she was little, her mom was like, oh, it's just an imaginary friend, just ignore her. But then her imaginary friend comes back when she's in high school, and the imaginary friend wants to kill her. So I'm like, I wonder if it's a ghost or if it's schizophrenia or whatever it is. So I'm really interested in reading it. Plus, another character also has an imaginary friend like hers. So I really... This was a spur of the moment one. I was looking through the books because I always look through the books at the library, even if I've already checked out 7 books because I ordered them. But this one sounded good, so I grabbed it. I got Possession by Alana Johnson. Yes, and this is the one, I think. Yes, this is the apocalyptic one, I think. And you're not allowed to walk with boys, and it sounds really good. And I love this. It's an ice cube with a butterfly in it. I mean, how awesome can you get? I mean, I got some books with awesome covers this week, so yeah, I don't know, it just sounds so good. Can't wait to read all of these books, like, really. I also got A Beautiful Dark by Jocelyn Davies, and the cover is just, seriously, all the covers that I got from books this week were amazing. I know this is an angel book, and I've heard good and bad things about it, so I'm going to try it. I saw it at Barnes & Noble's, and I didn't want to spend $18 on it, so I ordered it from the library, and so here it is. So hopefully I like it. I'll let you know. And then I have Cold Kiss by Amy Gravey. And this is the one I'm reading. I actually also wanted this from the library. Or not the library, Barnes & Noble. But it's also $18 and it's not that long. I love buying books for people that I like. Like, that I already know I like. Because I like her, but I didn't know that before. But I don't like spending too much money. I'm terrible, but I'm a college student, and I don't like spending so much money on one book, because, especially when it's thin, it's not that long, this is like almost 300 pages, and $18 is just too much money. So this was another one that I saw on the shelves, and I was like, oh, I need to get it. And I actually started reading it in the library, and so, yeah. It's good so far. It's about a girl who's brought back her boyfriend from the dead, because she has, like, these powers or something. So, it's pretty good so far. It's not the best book I've ever read, or even started reading, but, I mean, I'm on page 152 out of almost 300, so maybe something really interesting will happen. I hope. So, that's all I got this week. I hope you all have a good week. Starting a week from Sunday, I will actually be at home. Yay. So, until next semester, of course, but just for a few weeks in December, I will be home. I can't wait. So have a good week, and hopefully I'll see you on Sunday. Bye!